China continues to lord it over the South China Sea, with artificial islands now believed to be military capable, and soft power that has claimants like the Philippines hesitant in pushing their claims. But the country's former top diplomat finds a golden opportunity in the upcoming ASEAN summits, one this week and another in November.
We need to utilize our chairmanship to be able to place on the agenda a discussion on how to move forward given the tribunal outcome.
It was during Albert Del Rosario's term as Foreign Secretary that the country scored a landmark legal victory that struck down China's sweeping claim over the disputed waters and the Spratly Islands. The plan then was to rally international support to get China to comply with the ruling. ASEAN support would have been crucial, with four of its members claiming parts of the South China Sea. However, the Duterte administration has chosen a friendlier, one-on-one approach to China. The president has downplayed the arbitral ruling, saying he will bring it up at an opportune time. Del Rosario believes that time is now.
And I think the Philippines, for example, is in a position to set agenda. So I think it should exercise its leadership by making sure that the agenda is exactly what we would want it to be, and not be dictated to by China.
Del Rosario says ASEAN must push to include the arbitral ruling in the framework of the South China Sea Code of Conduct now in the works. Experts on the subject are wary of ASEAN's track record of disunity when it comes to the maritime disputes. They say ASEAN must take a stand now, or else China will continue to tighten its grip on the sea.
China will still, I think, be constrained to give way to some of ASEAN's demands if they unite.
And right now, the ball is in President Duterte's court as ASEAN chairman. JC Gotinga, CNN Philippines.